Hi honey bunches, welcome back to a vlog. I'm gonna vlog today, which is Saturday. I've woken up feeling a bit funky. That seems to be wearing off as I've spoken to more people. Gotten out of my head. I think I'm in a bit of a funk predominantly because I just haven't been proactive about thinking about videos for next week. And in the past, when I've left to the weekend, two don't really happen. One if I'm lucky. Anyway, I'm doing one now. We'll see if tomorrow produces another one. I slept in a bit this morning and then walked Harvey and went into the food shop. All before 10 because that's when I had to pick up Lexi, this dog that I usually dog walk, but the family that she's from are having a kid's birthday party and they wanted her out of the way, so she's here for 2 hours. It's going to be a very needy 2 hours though, because if I'm not in her line of sight, she's squeaking and whining. I should be thankful that I have a dog fan, right? Yes. And I guess the main plan is today is to make a vlog, make some good food, and also do another photograph for my postcard series of the soup that was in the last video. Yep, after I drop off Lexi, I'm gonna get some flowers and shoot that. I hope you're doing well. Thank you for all the really, really nice comments on the last video. Yeah, I really appreciate it. And hey, my skin is on the improve. So that's very exciting, and it's just kind of really great to not be on the steroid cream anymore. I think it's very important to know that if you have skin issues, there are literally 101 ways you could go about addressing them if you wish to, or get some relief from them if they're impacting your quality of life, or are itchy, or, you know, just making your face really inflamed or something like that. And that can be a really annoying thing because there are so many, and it's like, oh, there's so much to work through. Whether it's using medication, using a certain cream, monitoring your stress levels, making sure you get enough sleep, or washing your face more, or changing something with your diet, or just being super gentle on your skin, which is kind of the route I'm going. Yeah, there's heaps of options, and don't make one person feel like just cause one doesn't work for you means you are a failure. I can hear Lexi squeaking her head off, so I'm gonna go downstairs and make that soup while she can see me. Thank you. That always really takes it out of me because standing over and taking pictures like that is not great for your back. And obviously standing on stone makes your feet sore really quickly. Oh, but that's 5 of them now, so I only have one more. That's the plan in the postcard series, 6 of them. So one more to go, and with 1 week of uni left, or 1 week and then another week of finishing up assignments, that's pretty good. We're gonna save that soup for dinner, so I am gonna make a burger, although they didn't have the gluten-free fries chicken burgers, so I'm gonna make like a chicken nugget sandwich. Oh dear, but anyway, it should be fab. Extra crunch, if nothing else. So I finished The Handmaid's Tale, as you saw in the last vlog, and the next book I'm reading, the most predictable airport type book ever at the moment, Michelle Obama's Becoming. Something I was trying to think about and put into words this week, Honey Bunches, which I probably will majorly flop on my face here, but I'll try, is the concept of, I don't know how many of you have watched Hannah Gadsby's Netflix special, Nanette, or the TV series on Netflix special written by Ryan O'Connell, but the concept of internalized homophobia, or internalized ableism, like the concept of internalizing a societal hatred, attitude, fear of something, even when you are that thing yourself, I think. Along those lines, I was thinking how that sort of extends a lot more broadly, like looking beyond like internalized homophobia, we can just absorb and adopt and still have these like deeply rooted like societal attitudes to things. For example, driving home from uni, there's this billboard from Animals Australia, and it's just a very simple billboard to saying people, telling people to go vegan. And when I see that, like even though I am a vegan, I have this like instinctual immediate response, which is how society perceives vegans to be. Like vegans, like their message is everywhere, they're, it's a bit cringe, it's a bit facepalm, before I have the conscious, that's awesome, that's so cool that the billboard's there doing that on such a busy road, and it's just a nice billboard. So I don't know, can you relate to anything like this? I guess I have, yeah, just the vegan example, the whole YouTube example, like, don't necessarily feel comfy being a YouTuber. That feels a bit weird, even though I am one, and when people talk about it, when people talk about YouTube, I like cringe real hard internally, even though I am one. So yeah, I guess the moral of that thought process is that even if someone is something, like identifies as bi or a vegan, or they're a blogger, it doesn't mean they're like super comfortable with the label themselves. I guess that just comes to the whole thing, how helpful are labels really if we just swish them aside and let the person do the talking, and let them just be what they are. Probably a better way to roll, although in this day and age labels do help to communicate. I'm gonna eat these broken up end bits of brownies while watching some Friends to chill. Hey ho, just finished editing those photos and I lined them up with the others and it's coming along. But yeah, you all seen it all popped up on the screen. Today hasn't been like an out of this world productive day. Hope that's all right and it turns into a nice relaxing chill, but still gripping it video nonetheless. I think I'm gonna throw the ball for Harvey for a bit. Thank you.
last night as well.
Hello again. It's about 10 to 8. I've had a shower, finished dinner, read some more, watched some Friends, and I'm gonna plan my tomorrow. I'm quite pleased with myself. I know it's like a small thing, but I need to switch my attitude, which I'm getting a lot better at. But like, if I start off the day in a bit of a funk, I find it hard to turn it around. I very much have in the past, or like any day where I don't know exactly what the plan of attack is, what I'm gonna be taking off. You know, I'm not best at finding my purpose of the day midway through, but I'm getting better at that. And today was definitely an example of just going with the flow a bit more and realizing that like, it's a Saturday, I want to be recharging anyway. So doing chill things is absolutely fine. It doesn't have to be on a to-do list for it to be worthwhile, you know. I got my timetable for the last semester of my undergraduate yesterday, and it looks like I'll be in there 2-3 days a week. Could be 4, but also could be 2. But it's making it feel very real that I will not be at uni for forever, and in the quite soon foreseeable future, I'm gonna have to commence the post-uni thing. I don't know, I would love to know from people who are not too far out of uni, but on the other side of it, was it a super smooth transition for you and I just need to snap out of it, or do you have any tips for not losing your mind in the process? I took a gap year after school, and while it was amazing in many ways, I saved quite a bit of money. I sort of did a lot of HBOT stuff, I guess worked on my independence a bit, but it wasn't like I look at Unjada Jade, that study tuber from the UK, a glorious woman. I look up to her a lot, even though I guess she's 2-3 years younger than me. But just, yeah, her type of gap here is just like, whoa, like, I would love to be friends with you. You are phenomenal, and I love your values, and I think you're super cool and will be fun to hang out with. But at the same time, like, I don't think I would have survived her type of gap year of traveling a lot, just doing totally different, challenging things every single day. It's sort of a bit hard for me to admit because I feel like a failure of a person and a really boring person to admit that, like, change for me, like, I can do it and I know I execute it far better than I internally feel. But internally I can find it so stressful, and it can, you know, stress causes a lot of physiological things, whether it's skin stuff or digestive problems. Just making you feel really shaky and anxious, and that's hard even if you are actually, you know, executing it well and from the outside are smashing it. So I am very concerned about next year and how that will go, because there won't be like the routine of uni for 12 weeks at a time, but at the same time it doesn't mean there'll be no routine. And I've also had a gap year to teach me some lessons of how if you don't do certain things you can very much slip into a very poor state of mental health. I have had a period to learn my lesson, and hopefully it'll not be the same as that mental health wise. But yeah, anyway, tips galore, please send in. Just more generally about how to look after yourself mentally when you don't have that sort of routine. What the heck, this has gone so fast, and I know I'm not through it yet, but pretty much 2 more weeks of this semester and then another semester to go is not much. They fly by. And I know every uni system structure in different parts of the world is different, but as you can probably gather, since I'm home a lot, my contact hours for uni are not a huge amount. The sort of socializing, drinking scene, party type thing it's just not me. I don't enjoy it. It causes me more stress than pleasure, and so uni isn't like a whole hunk of my life, although I do work on it pretty much full time or around other things Monday through Friday. What was I gonna say? Oh yeah, but in case you are in a similar situation to me in your uni situation, in that you're not like living on campus and it's not your whole life, like, I feel like I've actually only made a really good friend in this current semester, just because, especially with arts cuts and how a lot of my classes are merely seminars and not tutorials, or it's been more like that the more I've gone on throughout my degree, which is frustrating because there's no room to like chat and banter and actually build a little friendship that you could then build more outside of class, but, you know, get it to a certain level in a seminar or lecture setting. It's just like the chances of you sitting next to someone in a lecture hall that you really gel with are pretty slim when there's like 250 people, you know. So anyway, you're not alone, and I guess it's awkward because like my parents, they like went to uni, made a phenomenal group of friends that like are my brother and my godparents. They like catch up all the time. They like they're friends that they've sort of built for life. They all had kids at around the same time and they were staying on campus and they were also going to uni interstate. You definitely hear the like uni story, the uni narrative of it being much more full time in someone's life, like a chapter in their life where like uni is everything that they're living and breathing. Yeah, you hear that more than I guess the uni sitch that is my current experience and heaps of others. I'm gonna go. Thank you for watching this video. I know it wasn't the best one I've ever made, but thank you for watching as always, Honey Bunches. See you on Instagram or in the next video. Love you and thank you for watching. Bye.